computer teacher. Today I will teach you class 9, chapter 9, programming technique. Friends, today I will teach you about programming technique. A program with a clear and logical structure is more likely to be a correct and maintainable than a program without a structure. The program design and code will both be easy to understand. As a result, the programmer should be able to detect errors and modify the program more easily. To produce a clear logical program design, we have to use good program design techniques. Let us look into some of these programming techniques: structured programming, modular programming, top-down approach of programming. First, I discuss about structure programming. Structured programming offers a number of benefits to its user. In this programming, each step is independent of the other steps, hence allowing separate checks at each step. Each step error may therefore be detected in a systematic manner. At any time, only a small amount of information has to be remembered and manipulated. The objective of structured programming is to provide methodology. So that these are the objective of structured programming. Programmers are developed quickly and fewer mistakes. Programs are read and understood easily. A portion of program can be modified without upsetting the functions of other portions. So these are the aim of structured programming. Now structuring of control flow. The idea behind the structuring of control flow is to keep the complexity of program under control, so that the design and understanding of the program logic become easier. The structured program can be completely developed using three basic forms of program structure. These are sequence structure, decision or selection structure, loop structure or repetition structure. Sequence structure. The sequence structure indicates the sequential flow of program logic. In a sequence structure, the statements are executed one after after the other in the order in which they are written. In this figure, this is the structure of sequence structure flow. The flow of control is such that it performs block X first, then block Y, and so on. And so on from top to bottom in the same direction. There is only one entry point and one exit point for the structure, and there is no complexity. The flow is in one direction. This is the structure of sequence structure. Now, decision or selection structure. In decision or selection structure, depending on input data, selection may be made among two or more ways of handling a processing task. The program takes one path or the other depends on whether a condition is true or false. The program, on entering the decision box, makes a decision to go through either of the two paths. After performing one of the two paths, the control refers to a single exit point. See the structure of decision box. Decision or selection structure. Here is we take the decision, and according to decision, the output is no or yes. Then we print output. Then the same end point is the point. Now, loop structure. Loop structure or repetition structure. The term loop refers to the need to cycle through a processing task or a set of processing tasks depending on input data. processing tasks are repeated a certain number of times or until some condition is met. A condition involves a test of the value of one or more data items. See the structure of loop structure. Here decisions. If the decision is no, the program loop will be stopped. If the decision is satisfied and it completed loop this time. It depends on condition. How many times are given to complete a loop? It may be 5 times, 10 times. Depends on the programmer. What are the conditions? That's all for today.